Now, the next two tools we're going to talk about are dictionary and translate. And with the dictionary and translate, you might not think of those as tools of inclusion, but if you have a student that is a second language student, then being able to translate a word or phrase back into their native language, or to be able to look up a word to see what it means in the English language, is important. Let's take the word highlighted. And I'm just going to highlight the word highlighted and click on dictionary. And we see it can't find it. Now, we use Wiktionary, which is an Oxford-style dictionary. And because of that, you normally have to drop the suffix like you do in a normal dictionary. Now, I'm going to highlight just the word highlight and click dictionary. And now we can see that it's telling us that we are using an online dictionary. It can be used as a noun and a verb and what the definitions are. Let's say we do not know what different learning preferences is in English, and we want to translate that to our native language, which maybe is French. Now, this tells us that we are using Google Translate, and you can see that down here. And it translates basically as different preferences learning. And we can listen to that.
Différentes préférences d'apprentissage.
For the French-speaking student, they would understand that. However, if I highlight the entire page or a paragraph or a sentence, Google Translate is going to go back to working as a word-by-word translation, which means it's not going to have the sentence structure correct in the other language. One other tool I want to mention here that you maybe don't realize can be a tool of accessibility, and I'm going to pause this real quick, is reading speed. Now, reading speed for a student that is a second language learner needs to be a little bit slower so that they can grasp the pronunciation of the words. If you're working in a very difficult subject matter, you might want to pull it down slower. If you're going into an area where information comes at you fast, you may want it a little bit faster. So that will help change how you want to do the reading speed. Let's listen to this, pumping it up just a little bit on speed.
Knowing where to find learner support is essential to your success.
And as you can hear, it was moving much faster now.